And so we're just going to begin. And so when you, even before you are called to the incident, you can start preparing your incident web map. And so you'll click on the incident web map template. Here, I'm going to jump right down. Sorry for the scrolling. We're working with the basic workflow, which starts out with the incident web map template. And so we'll open the item details, which again has links for the production template right here. And so also, if you don't have the workflow, the mobile workflow, you can find out how to utilize the template right here. So what we'll do is we'll open in Webmap Classic. Even though Webmap Viewer is available, we still highly recommend to open in Webmap Classic. So here you are. So what you need to do is to zoom into your fire area. So I'll zoom into my test fire. So this is my strawberry fire near the small community of Strawberry. It's not where I live, but I like the name. So I'll add a bookmark. And bookmarks make it easy for your field user and collector to be able to zoom to your area of interest. If you had a much larger fire and had different zones and all sorts of different divisions, to make it easier for your user to zoom in automatically, you could add those as bookmarks as well. And then after you do that, you'll save a copy of this. And when you do that, I'm going to leave training in here. And so I'll put that this is a web map for collector and the fire year. And then I'll leave the tags and add strawberry fire. Okay, so now I've created my new web map. It's not quite ready to share out yet. The next step is to create my own photo point template, because the photo point template that is installed here is just a placeholder. And so what I need to do now is go to my content, which is accessible from the tab up here. And then I'll go create feature layer from existing. Then I'll search for one that I would like to make a copy of, which is that template feature service. You can just click through these default. And then tag it. And then click done. But I've already gone through that process, and so here's the Strawberry Fire photo points, which is created now. What I'll do to add it to my map is scroll down and copy that URL. Go back to my fire, web map, add from layer, grab layer from web. There we go. And then I'll remove the template. And then I'll save again. See. Okay. And then the next thing I need to do is share this out to my mobile editing group. This is the way that your users and collector will have access to this group. You will most likely get this pop-up that says to update the sharing for a layer that you don't own, which is why it pops up, because the NFC authoritative account owns this, and just click OK. That doesn't affect your web map, nor does it affect the layer. It just allows it to be shared into the group. And so just to confirm, we will open up that group, mobile editing. And there's my web map. As you can, and also you can see that the photo points layer is shared into this group as well. The next thing we need to do is to invite our field workers into this, our FOBs and our other folks who will be in the field collecting data. So you'll just go in here and then search for people. We'll try to add Kathy. Oops. a lot of Hansons. It is very simple now to use the search function and to add new members to the group. Previously, it was a hassle to use the search function, but now it works quite well. One more thing we need to do is to check the settings for our web map, which is just the settings tab over here. We'll scroll down, look at the offline feature, and just make sure before you send people out into the field that offline mode is enabled. And doubly sure, you need to check your photo points and make sure that sync is enabled. Okay, and so once that's through, then for the basic workflow, you are done. You can send your field workers out there, they can start collecting data, and their data will start coming in and populating the map. As you can see, we've had some field workers out in the field collecting data already, which is fantastic. There's a photo point out there already. So it looks like things are working as planned. And so the next step is to go over the approval workflow. And the approval workflow, if you remember, begins with the incident web map template. And so you don't need to create another incident web map. You can just use the one that you've started already from the basic workflow. So taking this, you can either have your situation unit leader use the approver web app that is pre-configured, which you can find in the training resources group, and just view application. And then you will need to zoom into your fire, and then all of your features will populate. And as you can see here, and as discussed over in the user guide, all features with a red halo behind them mean that they've come in as proposed. Anything with a green halo means that it's been approved already. So the polygon, the fire perimeter, which I created in Pro, as well as the division breaks, I approved in Pro already. So we've had field workers who have come in and we've checked, let's see, we have a checkpoint. Let's see, no comments. Who is it by? So I see that Abby was out there in the fields, and I know that Abby was asked to collect some of these features. And so what I'll do as the situation unit, I'll highlight this point and I'll click approved and I'll save that. And then it goes green. Another thing you can do is that I've also asked Abby to go and collect the ICP location and the internet access there. And so I know that she's done that. And so I'm gonna batch approve those. And so I want to just approve those two points. We can see that they're both highlighted. Oops. You can approve more than one feature at a time. So let's see. Closures. So we've got lots of points. We've got this second or this planned handline. And as I mentioned before, features that are marked as proposed can be turned off with a definition query in Pro, and that can be used to make incident web maps. And so I'm going to leave this one as proposed. And also with folks who are using the view only web map, features that are shown as proposed will not populate that web map as well. I would like for the viewers to be able to see these drop points. And so I'm going to approve those. And you might notice that it's not an immediate effect. The web map that this app is based off of has a refresh interval of 1 minute. And so if you wanted to up that, you could go back. Actually, you couldn't. Sorry. Since this one is pre-configured, it is as is. And so if you wanted to refresh it automatically, you can just zoom in and then zoom out. Also within this pre-configured web app, we've turned geometry editing off. So I don't know if you've noticed, but if you were to configure the web app from the template web map, yourself. And you can create this web app using Web App Builder. It's fairly simple to do and to pre-configure all of the editing settings for each of the layers within this map. But turning the geometry editing off means that whoever has access to this map cannot accidentally move any of these features with just a click of the mouse, which has happened, and it's frustrating. There are no go backs in AGOL, unfortunately. There's no undo, as I'm sure most of you know, working on dashboards, which is frustrating. But for those of you who would like to make their own situation, you know, approver app, you can certainly do that in the training group, or in the training resources group. We have the CITL approver web map, and using that, you can create your own application from that as well. But using this pre-configured application, you can zoom in to any incident that you are on, and it works just fine. Everything is pre-configured for your use. Again, sorry for the scrolling. Okay, so for the view only web map, we'll go in to the resources group. Again, here's the item details, view and map viewer classic. And it will ask you almost every time when you open a new template web map if you want to view in the new map viewer. And please, she's not right now. I'll mention later. But if you were to configure one of these template web maps in the new map viewer, it allows you to configure web maps so they're not offline enabled any longer, which is unfortunate and frustrating. So that's why we ask you to still use the map viewer classic if you're using the web map templates. So zoom to your fire. And as you'll notice, the view only web map template, it is only displaying the features that have been approved. So we can go back quickly. Oops. And these are all the features approved and proposed. And then these are the ones that are just approved. And then you can save as. You could add your bookmarks if you like. Don't forget to add your photo point layer. From URL, and then to remove the template. As this web map is configured, as pre-configured, the only editable layer is the photo point template. And so it has to have at least one editable layer for the web map to go offline. If you would like to configure the viewer web map for your particular users, you can also change whether or not they can see features that are proposed as well. That would just be removing the filter. Every layer on this web map, except for the photo points, has the filter to only show features with the status of approved. And then share this map out to your viewer group. Again, you will get that pop-up message. And then you want to confirm within the viewer group, that web map template is in there. Add your users as they need to be. And again, these are only users that just are able to view, but not to edit. Okay. So once that's done, your users are off to the races in Collector. And now we've gone through, oh, sorry, one more thing I want to mention about the queries. So here's the pro definition query that utilizes the feature status. As mentioned, all of the features in the mobile National Incident Feature Service are, you cannot delete them, not in AGOL or in collector. However, you can say to delete this feature, you can say yes. So you want to query all of the features that have delete this set to yes. So you only want to display those with no. We've got feature status equals approve and is visible is yes.